Hello everybody, my name's Laksh and you're watching LM Tech. Hope everyone is safe and sound. Anyway, today I will be reviewing the Asus VivoBook 15X512FL. So without wasting any more time, let's get right into the video. In this review, we'll be covering looks, build quality, battery life, performance, and all other aspects of the laptop. So let's start up with a basic overview of the laptop. This is the Asus VivoBook X512FL. The model I have right here is the highest end model of the VivoBook 15 lineup. The price of the VivoBook lineup starts at 34,000 rupees or $450 for our international friends. So the first thing we notice are the looks. The Asus VivoBook 15 comes with this seamless narrow bezel design that Asus calls Nano Edge Display. Honestly speaking, I am a big fan of this design. The design gives you a very premium look. The laptop has an 88% screen to body ratio, which is just amazing for the price. The bezels are just 5.7 millimeters thin. The laptop comes in 4 different colors, namely Peacock Blue, Slate Gray, Coral Crush, and the one I have right here, Transparent Silver. The laptop just weighs 1.6 kilograms, which is very lightweight for a laptop at this price. The top section of the laptop is completely made out of metal and the bottom is made out of hard plastic. This is a 15.6 inch laptop but is fitted in a 15 inch footprint, which is due to the extremely thin bezels. This makes the laptop more compact. One amazing feature that differentiates this laptop from other laptops is the Ergo Lift hinge, which means that when you open up the laptop, it gives the keyboard a 2-degree hinge. Now you may ask, what is the use of this? The Ergo Lift hinge tilts the keyboard by 2 degrees, which makes typing more comfortable. If you look carefully, it leaves a space between the surface and the laptop, which leaves some gap for the hot air to escape. This is really helpful as it keeps the laptop cool and prevents the laptop from heating. This is a really smart move from Asus. One more thing that makes this laptop different from others is the presence of a fingerprint scanner. Yes, you heard it right, a fingerprint scanner. This is not a phone, this is a laptop. The fingerprint scanner is located at the top right corner of the touchpad, which makes authentication much more faster and easier. Now let's talk about the touchpad. The touchpad felt very smooth and could easily recognize gestures like pinch to zoom, or swipe 2 fingers to shift, or swipe down 3 fingers to go to the desktop. I did not find any dead zones except the little area over the fingerprint scanner, which does not make quite a difference. The touchpad has 2 dedicated left and right click buttons, which felt nice and clicky. The touchpad is big enough to make your pointer reach the other end of the screen, so no complaints regarding the touchpad. The laptop comes with a nicely sized backlit keyboard. The brightness of the backlit keyboard can also be controlled by using the F7 key. The keyboard has a dedicated number pad, which makes it perfect for all Excel fans and people who do a lot of data entry. The quality of the arrow keys was good. The overall keyboard quality was also very good and all the keys were comfortable to use. The function buttons come with some shortcuts to control volume, brightness, and to disable the touchpad. Now let's move on to the connectivity. The laptop comes with one USB 3.0 port, which will give you some fast speed, two USB 2.0 ports, a Type-C Thunderbolt port, which is a must nowadays. You also get one HDMI port, one audio jack, a micro SD card reader, and a DC in port. One port that this laptop lacked was an SD card port. So for that, you will need to buy a special type of USB A to SD card reader. This can be a flaw if you own a camera like me. So now let's talk about the speakers. The VivoBook 15 is equipped with 2 down-firing stereo speakers. The speakers come with Sonic Master technology, which is actually Asus's own tech. The speakers were not loud enough and did not sound that good. I hope the sound quality could be improved in upcoming models. Honestly, I was not a big fan of the speakers of this laptop. So here is a sound sample. Now let's talk about one of the most important things of a laptop, the display. The Vivobook comes with a full HD 1080p IPS panel. This has an anti-glare display, so don't expect a reflective glossy screen. The display comes with a 60Hz refresh rate, which is good for a non-gaming laptop at the price. It offers up to 45% NTSC color gamut. The bezels in this laptop make the display look much more immersive. The laptop comes with 178 degrees viewing angle. The brightness of the laptop was good considering the price point. However, the vertical viewing angles were not so good. A bit of a tilt and the colors get completely washed out. Overall, I will give the display 7 out of 10 marks. Now let's talk about the most important thing, the technical specifications. The Asus Vivobook 15X512FL comes pre-installed with Windows 10 Home. The laptop I have comes with the Intel Core i7 8th generation 8565U CPU, which has 4 cores and 8 threads. The base clock speed of this CPU is 1.8 GHz. However, Asus has added turbo boost till 4.6 GHz. What that means is when you're performing heavy tasks like video or photo editing or playing games, the speed kicks up to 4.6 GHz. This is an amazing feature for the price. There's also another variant of the laptop that costs lesser. This variant comes with the Intel Core i5 8th generation 8265U CPU with a base clock speed of 1.8 GHz and turbo boost up to 3.9 GHz. So you can go with this variant if you are on a tight budget. Now one more amazing thing in this laptop is the presence of a discrete GPU or graphics card. If you are into heavy graphics related stuff like gaming and editing, this laptop comes with a dedicated GPU or graphics card. This laptop comes with the NVIDIA MX250 GPU with 2GB VRAM. Now this can really pump up the graphics performance of the laptop. At this price point, this is a very good graphics card and it is something you must have. The laptop has 8GB of DDR4 RAM, which is expandable up to 16GB using one empty DIMM slot. I recommend upgrading the RAM if you are into gaming or editing. Talking about storage, you are getting 512GB of SSD or solid state drive. You can also expand the storage if you need. Now we will talk about the battery life. Since I have been using this laptop since a week, the battery life was decent. Asus claims that you are going to get about 10 hours of battery life on performing basic tasks like web browsing on battery saver mode. But if you are into gaming or using any heavy software, the battery will just last you for about 2 to 3 hours. So make sure you have a power cord nearby. Now it's time to put the laptop to the test. Now as you can see, I have opened up Adobe Premiere Pro and I am going to make a small clip, add transitions, motion graphic templates and some effects, and let's see how it turns out. Some major factors that contribute to the fast working of this laptop is the teamwork among an Intel Core i7 8th generation, a discrete GPU, and the fact that the Ergo Lift hinge allows the laptop to remain cool even when performing heavy tasks. While using it for 1 week, I did not face any sort of heating issues. So I have not rendered any of these clips and as you can see, it's working pretty smoothly but is playing with a bit of lag, which should be fine after you give it a render. Now let's come on to the gaming performance. Please keep in mind that this is not a gaming laptop. However, you can play some less demanding games at medium settings. You can also expect some decent frame rates. So that's it for today. If you enjoyed, please subscribe and like, as such videos take in tons of effort in the making. If you have any suggestions or questions, feel free to comment and I will surely reply. So bye bye and take care.